Are you so excited? It's almost out.
It's crazy. It's almost here.
Deeper Well is out at midnight tonight. I want to get into the album. I want to talk about everything. By the way, I love this color vinyl, too. Look at
this. Thank you. And my little sister, she shot the cover.
No way.
Yes, isn't that cool?
It is very cool. I love this.
And all the photos, yeah.
I love all the ducks.
Yes.
We have to talk about this, because last month you added another Grammy to your shelf. Seven Grammys?
Yeah, what?
I mean, you're
who's
amazing.
Counting? Who's counting?
Yeah, who's counting? Yeah, I am.
I
you won Best Country Performance by a Duo with Zach Bryan.
Yes.
For I Remember Everything.
Yes!
How is that guy?
Oh, my God.
How is he?
Incredible. Like, yeah. I'm such a fan, and it was so...
Me too. Yeah. He's got a cool story.
So, yeah.
Yeah, and you guys sound great together.
That's Thank you.
Hopefully we hear more of that. You know, you're the first artist to win a Grammy in the top four categories.
That's what they said. Yeah. I'm like, how is that possible?
That's you, bud.
I didn't know that that was a thing.
You're Casey Musgraves.
No, stop,
yeah, you're
stop,
no,
stop,
that's
stop,
who
stop,
you are.
Stop.
And tonight, Deeper Well is out at midnight tonight. We just said. I gotta say this because maybe the audience saw me. I was smelling the album because you did something very cool. You made the what's scented in here? Is the album?
The sleeves.
The sleeve.
The sleeve is scented. I didn't even know that that was a thing, but yeah, it smells like cow. Grass.
No, no, it isn't.
I wanted a real visceral.
I smelled the other side.
Yeah, it smells like duck poop. We wanted to bring a 3D experience, but no.
It smells great.
It smells
fresh. It smells like the outdoors.
It honestly does smell so good. I did a collab with Boy Smells. I basically turned the song Deeper Well into a scent, which was a really fun collaboration. It's like, you know, imagining like how would a song smell?
Yeah.
And so we did that and we kind of infused it into this paper, which is crazy. I'm like, I hope it smells good in, you know, 5 years.
yeah, who knows? Yeah. When you have this finally come out, are you happy it's like finally out there? Like, these are all my thoughts and I worked so hard on this album?
Yeah, I think, you know, releasing a creative project, I don't know if you feel this way, but it's such a process of letting go. And you know, these songs are written from a very intimate, personal place, and then, you know, you release them, and they kind of become everyone else's, and they, you know, attach their own meanings and stuff to it, too. So it's, like, bittersweet in a way, because I feel like once you release it, it's kind of not yours anymore. It's others, but I think the whole point is...
Yeah, because you'd be like, they're like, this song reminds me of my grandma, and you're like, I wrote it about laundry.
exactly.
Yeah, of course, it's about your granny. Exactly, yeah.
No, but it's like summer camp, you know, making a record. You're with your friends and you're hanging out for like, you know, this was like a year and a half or so in the making.
You were here, you did a lot of recording at Electric Lady.
Yes.
Here in New York City.
You love that studio, right?
It's my fave, it's the Roots, it's everyone's fave. We love that studio.
Yeah, there's some really amazing mojo in that building. You feel it when you walk in. I mean,
you do, right?
It's
I love
no
Lee.
Wonder. Yes,
Lee is
a
the
legend,
best. He's
a
the
freaking
best.
Legend. But yeah, I was always on the lookout for the ghost. I never saw any, but
you
no.
Never saw Jimi Hendrix anywhere.
I never saw him come.
I hung out with him a couple nights.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I want what you were having.
Did you have fun while you were in the city? Did you enjoy the city?
Oh my God, I love New York so much. Yeah. It's really inspiring.
It's a great place.
No, I mean,
it's a great place.
Like, I think it's cool as a creator to come here because you're, you know, in a 30-second span of walking down the street, you're hit with every language, every culture, you know, every type of person.
Yes.
Like colors, signs, smells.
Great people watching.
You know, amazing people watching. So it's inspiring in that way. You know, it's all these levels of humanity.
It's over by the village,
it's
right?
It's in the heart of Greenwich Village, you know, like folk central. Yeah, walk through Washington Square Park to get there. It's like, there's reggae, there's like, it smells like weed, it smells like piss, it smells like, it's like, yes!
Yeah, okay, I can see where the scent is now coming
that,
in now.
Yeah,
you.
Exactly.
Ah, that's what this is, yeah.
No, it's really inspiring.
You filmed your music video for the first single in Iceland.
Yes.
And it's gorgeous, by the way. It's for Deeper Well. I want to actually show a little bit of it right here. Look at this video.
I found a deeper well.
I mean, it's gorgeous. That's like a movie right there. That's beautiful.
It's like a mini movie.
Beautifully shot.
Have you ever been there?
I've never been to Iceland. No, I'm dying to go.
It's like another planet.
It really is,
it's amazing.
Right?
I mean, it's like Dune. The movie Dune was like very green. It's that.
It's Dune.
It's kind of got those vibes. It's kind of sci-fi, but it's really earthy. It's amazing.
You told me it was very windy there.
Okay. So we picked literally the worst possible week to go. I was so excited. It was on my bucket list. I was like, oh my God. And it couldn't, it was like high wind advisories. I almost got blown off that cliff.
Oh my God.
I was almost like, this video will be my death announcement. It was a sheer drop down to the ocean.
Oh my God.
We were like, I mean, it was treacherous. And even the locals were like, this is some scary.
This is not normal.
Yeah.
Yeah, you actually sent us a little behind the scenes video of what that beautiful video looked like. Here was what was really happening. Watch this.
Scary. It was scary.
Are you kidding me? Come on.
No,
that's really windy.
Literally grown men, like gigantic grown men were like
falling down. Yeah.
Praying.
Did you do any touristy things while you're there?
Yeah, you know, you guys have heard of the Blue Lagoon, right?
Blue Lagoon, yeah.
Yeah, the Blue, you see the pictures, it's so serene. You're like, people are floating. It looks like a Nirvana experience.
About.
I'm like, let's do that.
Yes.
So we venture out there. And no, honestly, they
didn't happen either.
It's sort of like a Instagram versus reality situation. We get there and it's like hurricane force wind. I'm surprised they didn't close down the thing. There was only a few locals there and then us, and we were like getting body slammed by waves, and it was like,
wait, there's waves? I thought it was like a serene cave or something.
Well, no, it's like a pool. It's supposed to be like a very placid,
like a steam cave or something. It's
they
called.
Have a steam cave. I never found. I just wanted to find the steam cave.
You didn't find this.
No. Okay, so
let's take a look at your experience in this steam cave.
Oh my God.
Casey.
It's like a wave pool.
Where is the steam cave?
Does anyone know? And they give you a free drink. You get a free beer when you're there. And I was like, at all costs, just protecting the free
just
beer.
Protect just protect the beer.
Yeah.
Protect the beer at all costs,
It was really fun. It was a wild, I'll never forget that experience.
Did you see the Northern Lights?
Jimmy.
I'm just saying, there's things to do.
Iceland, like, it delivered, but it also didn't at the same time. All I wanted to see was the Northern Lights.
Yeah,
like,
me too.
Bucket list, like, top.
It looks fake to me.
It looks fake. It looks like a screensaver or something, right?
Yes, it does.
Yeah, so all week the weather was just like, it was just terrible. And it was like, you know how they have the predictions, like the aurora predictions?
Yep.
So on the last night, it was the best possible conditions. So we're like, oh, maybe we'll get to see it. Well, one of my sweet managers, Bobby, he's backstage. He's such a champ. He went into dad mode. He's like, I know you want to see the Northern Lights, kid. And we were all so, so tired from this like rigorous shooting, but he's like, If you wanna go see the Northern Lights, I'll take you. We got the rental van. It looks like the clearest spot's gonna be about 2.5 hours from here, but we can do it. I was like, I mean, YOLO, Bobby. Like, we only live once.
Yeah. YOLO, Bobby.
So Bobby and I, like, we loaded up in the passenger van, and we drove like 2.5 hours. We had a really early call time the next morning, so we were like, but we gotta see the Northern Light. We gotta do this, you know? Yeah. We gotta just see it through.
Of course.
So we're like, we're driving. I mean, it's like, there's not a soul out there. It's pitch black. We're just going. Hour passes by, 2 hours. We're like, are you seeing them?
We're
like, wait,
when
did
they start
we
now?
We saw like a faint, we're like, is that? No, that's
is that
not,
the
is
sun?
That them?
That's the
is
sun's that... rising. Yeah,
yeah. So we're like, should we just go just a little further? And so we went a little further and we're like, I think maybe that's them. I think that's them.
That feels good enough for you.
Sure. Like, we saw a little, and I was like, all right, I'll take it. So we just were like, all right, it's late. We got an early call time in the morning. So we're speeding back. We're speeding back to the hotel and just taking our little Northern Lights experience and just, you know, trying to be satisfied enough with that.
Yeah.
About 2 weeks later, Bobby gets something in the mail, and apparently we broke the law in Iceland. So...
What happened?
Well, we got a speeding ticket.
By mail?
By mail, and it was a printed out piece of paper, and it was $10. So it was it was worth it, obviously. But I actually framed it for Bobby for Christmas. But what's funny about it is they included a photo. I never saw anything take our photo, but if you want to show them, you can see us in the van. Can you zoom in?
Kidding me?
Okay. look at Bobby's face.
Look at Bobby.
Wait, come down here. Yeah. So, look at Bobby. He's like,
those Northern Lights were fantastic.
Yeah. And we always make fun of him because he sighs so loudly. He's like, That's sorry, fantastic. Bobby. But anyway, he's sighing in this picture, and I'm just like,
$10
I'm along for the ride.
Ticket. Yeah, why not? Go for
anyway.
It. Big news, you just announced that your Deeper Well World Tour is kicking off. A world tour. We get to see you on tour. It's going to be great. April 28th, it kicks off in Dublin, Ireland.
Yay!
Dublin is a fun place.
Oh, my God. I love Dublin. I love Ireland so much. The Irish people are so fun, you know, and they love country music and songwriters over there. I think there's, like, you know, kind of a kindred spirit between traditional Celtic folk music and kind of bluegrass and folk and country. And so we always have an amazing time there. So I'm so excited to kick it off in this beautiful little theater there.
Congratulations. So. Deeper Well World Tour.
Yeah.
In honor of your tour. Kicking off in Ireland and St. Patrick's Day coming up. I thought we'd maybe toast with a couple.
Oh, a wee little pint. Is this real?
This is real.
Are you going to chug it?
No.
Okay.
This is it for good luck.
Cheers.
Casey Musgraves, everybody. Congrats. Good luck. Break a leg. Congratulations. Casey Musgraves, Deeper Well is out at midnight tonight. And she performs for us later. We'll be right back with Deion Sanders.